students, today I'm going to continue with the chapter which we have already started in our live class, that is adverbs and degrees of comparison. Okay, and today we are going to start from page number 120. So open page number 120 of your grammar book. The name of the chapter is adverbs and degrees of comparison, and what we are going to do is we are going to deal with we are going to deal with interrogative and exclamatory adverbs. Okay, so what are interrogative adverbs? Interrogative adverbs are those adverbs which are used to ask questions. Okay, I think I have already discussed this. Interrogative adverbs are those adverbs which are used to ask questions like where, how, when. Okay. Next come to exclamatory adverbs. Exclamatory adverb express degree or extent in exclamations. Exclamatory adverb are adverbs like what, how. Okay, what a beautiful sight, how lovely is the dress, or how beautifully he danced, like that. Okay, how and what, they are used to express sudden, like why do we use the exclamatory form? We use it to express extent in exclamation. Okay, so degree or extent in exclamation, for that purpose we use the exclamatory adverb. An adverb of assertion and negation. What are adverbs of assertion and negation? So adverbs of assertion, affirmation and negation, they express either affirmation of something or denial of something. Like she will definitely come, that is an adverb of affirmation or assertion, definitely. Or she will not come, not is the adverb of negation. Okay, so it's very simple to identify that. Now come to exercise number F. In exercise F, what you have to do is, you will have to this is exercise number F, page number 120. F number 1, why are you upset today? Number 2, when was the plan changed? In this sentence also you could have used why was the plan changed, but since we have already used why once, we can use when was the plan changed, or you can even use how was the plan changed, so it's not difficult. Then number 3, where did you find your lost bangle? Place, obviously, find. This one also you can write, when did you find your lost bangle, that is also doesn't make it wrong. How was the match today? Or in number 3 you can write, how did you find your lost bangle? And here number 4 you can write, where was the match today? So it's all right, okay, as long as it makes the proper meaning. Number 5, just don't repeat, use the same one in two places. Who discovered America many centuries ago? Okay, so these are all the answers of exercise F. Now we are going to deal with the next exercise. Before that, let us just discuss how to place adverbs, the position of adverbs. How do we understand where to place the adverb? Okay, so let us deal with each of the rules which are given. The position of an adverb in a sentence determines its meaning. Okay, so adverb of manner, place and time are placed between the subject and the verb if the verb consists of one word. So this is the first rule which is given here. Let me just write one rule and then the rest we can simply discuss. Adverb of manner or time or place are placed, generally placed, okay, not all the time, there are certain exceptions. They are placed between the subject and the verb if the verb consists of a single word. If the verb consists of a single word. Okay, come to the next rule. Adverbs can come in three positions in a sentence. In the beginning of the sentence, so the position of adverbs can be three. It can be in the beginning of a sentence, it can be in the middle of a sentence, or at the end of the sentence. Okay, so it has three positions in a sentence: beginning, middle or end. Next is an adverb of time may be placed right at the beginning of a sentence for emphasis. Like if I say recently I purchased a big bookcase, okay, or a big bookshelf. Recently I purchased a bookshelf. So if you want to emphasize something, adverb of time may be placed right at the beginning. Okay, that is when we want to emphasize. If there is stress on the verb form of be or on the auxiliary, then the adverb usually comes before it. If there is an object, the adverb is generally placed after the object. But if the object is very long, we usually put the adverb before the verb. Okay, so these are all the rules which you have to study. When an adverb modifies an adjective or adverb, the adverb normally comes before it. So if it is modifying, like he played exceptionally well. Okay, so this is the adverb which is modifying the another adverb, which is well. So when it is modifying another adverb, then it will be placed just before the adverb. Okay, so like this, a lot of different rules are given in the book. Then adverb enough is always placed after the word it modifies. After the word it modifies, it will come. Okay, the adverb enough is placed right after the word it modifies. Right after the word it modifies. Next is adverb of frequency, degree, manner are placed before the verbs have to and used to. So if you write he sometimes used to skip lunch, so adverb of frequency and degree, if used to or have to is given, it will come before it. Then if there are two or more than two adverbs after a verb, the adverb of manner comes first, followed by adverb of place and then adverb of time. So if in a sentence both all three types of adverbs are there, then what sequence will we follow? First will come adverb of manner, followed by adverb. First it will come adverb of manner will come, then adverb of place will come, and finally adverb of time will come. this is all about it. We will just and let us insert the correct adverb suitably in the sentences below. I spoke to him, and two words are given, somewhere and briefly. So either of the two words you have to insert. Both the adverbs you don't have to, anyone you can use. So it will be briefly, obviously. I briefly spoke to him. I briefly spoke to him, as it is an adverb of manner, and it has to be placed after the subject, before the verb. Number two, she drinks milk daily for strong muscles. Okay, she drinks milk daily for strong bones. Okay, because we know that adverbs of degree and manner, degrees and frequency, adverbs of degree and frequency, if you want to place them right at the beginning of the sentence, that is perfectly fine, because that shows emphasis. But for normal sentences, this will be like this. Okay, so let me just tell you the answers of exercise number G from the beginning once again. Okay, just wait, let me use the board for this, or I might actually tell you the answers and I think you will be able to get it. So the first one is, I briefly spoke to him. She drinks milk daily for strong bones. They never went to the park. They never went to the park. Number four, he will do this work willingly. He will do this work willingly. Number five, the coach gently encouraged the handicapped boy to run again. The coach gently encouraged the handicapped boy to run again. Number six, Rita has twice changed her school. Okay, so twice is an adverb of frequency, and adverb of frequency are generally placed after the helping verb, and if there is only one verb in the sentence, it is placed before the main verb. Okay, since it is an adverb of frequency, it will be placed after has, which is the helping or auxiliary verb, before the main verb. So Rita has twice changed her school. Number seven, my cousins gladly accepted my invitation. We have already learned that if the verb consists of only one word, the adverb of manner will be placed before between the subject and the verb, and since gladly is an adverb of manner, it will be placed after the subject, cousins. Number eight, a contented man seldom craves for materialistic things. A contented man seldom craves for materialistic things. Seldom is again an adverb of frequency, and so it will be placed right before the main verb. Okay. Number nine, my teacher was quite shocked at the boy's rude behavior. My teacher was quite shocked at the boy's rude behavior. And number 10 will be, she works hard. Okay, so I'm repeating from number one. I briefly spoke to him. She drinks milk daily for strong muscles. Okay, why did I use daily after this? When there is an object of the verb given, the adverb will be placed after the object. Number three, they never went to the park. Number four, he will do this work willingly. Number five, the coach gently encouraged the handicapped boy to run again. Number six, Rita has twice changed her school. Number seven, my cousins gladly accepted my invitation. Number eight, a contented man seldom craves for materialistic things. Number nine, my teacher was quite shocked at the boy's rude behavior. Number 10, she works hard. Okay, so come to the next exercise, which is exercise number 8. Make adverbs from the adjectives given here. So you just have to change them into adverbs. So number 1 will be loudly. Number 2 will be beautifully. Number 3 will be merrily. Number 4 will be satisfactorily. Number 5 will be highly, and number 6 will be gladly. Okay. Next come to exercise number I. Use the words given here to frame separate sentences. Use them as adjectives and adverbs. So this is going to be a homework for you, because you have to make sentences using them. Okay. So this will be a homework. You have to use these words as adjectives as well as adverbs. Well, this exercise is not important for your exam, so you may skip it. But if you do it, you can obviously send it to me for correction. I will check it. Exercise J. You have to transform the adjectives into adverbs and rewrite the sentences. Okay. Tina is an efficient worker. Tina works efficiently. Similarly, number 2, the old lady took a brisk walk through the garden. The old lady walked briskly through the garden. The old lady walked briskly. So you'll just add ly to the word brisk and make it an adverb, and then you will transform the sentence in this fashion. The old lady walked briskly through the garden. Number 3, suddenly there was a change in their outlook. Okay, suddenly there was a change in their outlook, or there was a change in their outlook suddenly. Both are correct. Number 4, the lion roared loudly. The lion roared loudly. The lion roared loudly. Or this one. Number 3 also you can write. Their outlook changed suddenly. Their outlook changed suddenly. Number 3, their outlook changed suddenly, and the lion roared loudly. Okay. Number 5, the Sensex rose sharply. The Sensex rose sharply. Number 6, he spoke eloquently. So what is the spelling of eloquently? Just add an ly to the word eloquent and change the sentence by changing eloquent into an adverb. I'm hoping that you are able to understand what I'm trying to tell you. You have to write the sentences in the copy, and in the sentences which are given, adjective is used. We are going to transform these adjectives into adverbs by adding ly to them, and then make the necessary changes to get them into the sentence in the same meaning. Okay. So number 6, he spoke eloquently. Number 7, they sang melodiously. They sang melodiously. Number 8, he performed impressively. He performed impressively. Okay, so I'm going to repeat once again exercise number J for you. Exercise J, you have to transform the adverbs in adjectives into adverbs and then rewrite the sentences. Okay, so number 2, the old lady walked briskly through the garden. Number 2, the old lady walked briskly through the garden. Number 3, their outlook changed suddenly. Their outlook changed suddenly. Number 4, the lion roared loudly. The lion roared loudly. Number 5, the Sensex rose sharply. The Sensex rose, R-O-S-E, rose sharply. Number 6, he spoke eloquently. He spoke eloquently. Number 7, they sang melodiously. They sang melodiously. Number 8, he performed impressively. Now we are going to come to the degrees of comparison of adverbs. Just like adjectives can be changed into adverbs, adverbs can also have a number of degrees of comparison, just like the adjectives does. Okay. So adverbs which ends in ly form their comparative by adding more and most to it, while there are different types, more and most will do. and like carefully, it will be more carefully, most carefully. Okay, so like that. Okay, so like carefully, it will be more carefully, most carefully. Cautiously will be more cautiously, most cautiously. But then some other words are also there which do not have ly to it, like far. It will be farther and farthest. Okay, so much like adjectives. Then well, better, best. Okay, so fill in the blanks using the appropriate forms of the adverbs given in bracket according to the sentence. So come to exercise number K in your book. Akbar ruled his empire more wisely, because the comparative form, we can see that Dan is given, so we'll have to use the comparative form. Okay, so more wisely. Number two, of Rita and Neha, who lives nearer to the market? Nearer. Number three, Amit reached late for the function while Sana reached later than him. So Amit reached late for the function while Sana reached later than him. Number four, of all the players who participated, Roger Federer played best. Okay, because of all the players, he played the best, superlative degree. He rode the horse more swiftly. Okay. So other important adverbs, enough is being given. Come to exercise number L. Exercise M, you will do it on your own. Not important for exam, but you will still do it. It's very easy. Come to exercise number L. He felt, now this one also, I think if you do it on your own, it will be very easy for you, because some of the words which are there, it can come in more than one places. So let me put, he felt too tired to walk further. She fared well enough in the creative competition. Number three, she worked diligently to achieve her goals. Number four, Ruchi visited her parents regularly. The little boy nervously picked up his books. Number six, the girl went away in a boat. The bicycle fell sideways. Number eight, the play was much appreciated by all. Number nine, mother was very disappointed. She felt much better. Much is given twice. So I'm just going to repeat it and then this chapter is done. I hope that you will have no problems with it. But if you have any problem, please ask me in the live class. Okay. So number one will be TOO2. Number two will be enough. Number three will be diligently. Number four will be regularly. Number five will be nervously. Number six will be away. Number seven will be sideways. Number eight will be much. Number nine will be very. And number 10 will be much. Okay, thank you students. I hope that you have understood the chapter adverbs very well. Thank you.